You know, we enter the salat with no emotions whatsoever, no feelings whatsoever. While when we meet with someone that we like, a friend that we like, we have so much joy and happiness. As a matter of fact, when they leave, we miss them. But subhanAllah, when we leave the salat, we feel nothing. When we are in a meeting with Allah Azza wa Jal, we feel nothing. Insha'Allah ta'ala, tonight with the new key, that will change. What is the new key? It is the key of Raja, the key of hope. To have this feeling of hope before we enter the salat. What does that mean? It's to have the hope that Allah, inshallah, Allah will have mercy upon me in that salat. I am going to be asking Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive me in that salat. And He will, inshallah ta'ala. I am going into that salat with the hope, with raja, that Allah will forgive me and Allah will have mercy upon me. When we go inside the salat with this kind of emotion, it will change everything. What's the use of, I understand what I'm saying and I have a comfort, the heart present, but at the same time, I have no feeling whatsoever. Everything is mechanical. Allahu Akbar, subhanAllah, alhamdulillah. What is the feeling? I'm in meeting with the one that I love the most. Don't we claim that we love Allah Azza wa Jal the most? I'm in a meeting with Him right now. So let's show that hope of Allah Subhanahu wa Taala forgiving us. How can we get that feeling of raja? Is by the more we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more we will have raja in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has more mercy upon me and you more than our own mothers. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all we have to do in order to gain that feeling of raja is to think well of Allah Azza wa Jal. Think well of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, He is as you think of Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you think that Allah is going to forgive you, He will forgive you. If you think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have mercy upon you, Allah will have mercy upon you. I am as my servant think of me. Allah said in the Hadith al-Qudsi, He said, I am as my servant think of me. So before I enter the salat, I come to the salat with the feeling that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive me. Allah will have mercy upon me. Allahu Akbar. Can you imagine how would that salat be? Instead of just coming in, Allahu Akbar. No, I just pause for a second. I am about to be forgiven. I am about to ask Allah for His mercy. And subhanAllah, and then I start the salat. So that's a very beautiful key. And because some people always think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to accept my tawbah. Allah is not going to forgive me. No. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell all my servants, the ones who have transgressed, they did not leave a sin, they did not commit. They commit all sins. Tell them, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا. Don't ever give up upon the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah is the all merciful. He's the all forgiving. Allah forgives the dhunub jami'a, all of it. All of the dhunub Allah will forgive. Whatever you have committed, Allah will forgive. So Allah is what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is what we think of Him. We think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to forgive us, He will forgive us. We think that Allah is going to let us into Jannah, He will let us into Jannah.